Well, I think this could be it. Gosh, it took me a long time. I think what it was, I completely forgot. I didn't see this spot here when I was starting to make my moves. I got so excited when Ken and Meandering Mike validated that I could go across here and avoid the trench. And then I got so excited just seeing this, and I forgot about the woods. Anyways, I started streaming some of my five movement point. I think it's the 35th. We'll find out in a minute. Anyways, towards here, but I can't because that would have been 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 to get into it. So I can't do it. Oh, well. But I did figure out how to get troops over there. I just had to redo all this flipping stuff. It was just nuts. hold on. I'm just going to blow my little thingamajig. And then I'll zoom in a bit more. I don't really know if we need to do that much, but there is a couple of things I'm going to do. Hold on, I'm going to have to zoom out again so you can see. There we go. I think the first move is I'm going to create a couple of core HQs over here, and they're going to rail on over. One's going to go over to here, and one's going to go over there. Oh, hold on, and then let's see here. Yep, 9th Army HQ at 1506 in Konigsberg there. It's going to create Core HQ 9, which is going to turn into, it can't be BG-12, it'll have to be something else. I'll give it BG-18, let's say, yeah. Or no, let's go 72. 18. Alright. And they're going to get rail. They're going to entrain, then rail to the fortress at 2010 and detrain. So they're going to go all the way, so they're going to end up going from here to here. And there they are. They're in that fortress. Then I'm going to create Core HQ 10, and they're going to be number 19, and they're going to entrain and rail to the fortress in Culm at 0915 and detrain. So this is going to be part of Charles Tortoise's work to do later. So there we go. I've got, if you can just see it, hold on. Just, all right. Come on, you. There we go. So, yeah, we'll have there, and that'll be one of the centers, what I'm calling, I think I called it the Bromberg what did I call it? The Garrison Corps, the Bromberg Garrison Corps. It's going to be over here. Yep. Yeah, I'm sorry, I'm a bit sidetracked right now. Maybe I shouldn't be doing this video, but I want to get it done. All right, so we got that bit there. There's just been a lot going on this week, right? Right, there we go again. I did go for a walk, so that was nice out in the woods. Just to kind of clear my head a little bit. All right, is that good enough? Let's see where I'm going. Yeah, let's maybe a wee bit more, and that's about it, I think. You don't need to see too. Yeah, it's just whatever's. I think you just want to see the positional stuff more than anything, I assume. All right, so here we go. So there's a bunch of troops here. A bunch. And what I'm going to start doing now is I need to shuffle all these guys up towards here and just spread, spread a little bit here, but not, I don't want to start, just want to take it easy. But I want to start putting some stuff here, and then I'm going to strip one of the divisions that's here. I think it's the 36th Reserve Infantry Division. I'm going to bring, it's at 5 points. I'm going to bring it all the way down to one, and it's going to be built up. There's a 5 point replacement unit there. Unfortunately, I'm not going to be able to use all five. There'll be one left, but at least it's the start. I'm going to get going. I would like to move some of my high strength point divisions from here, like a lot of the 8s and whatnot, so I could bring down seven and then, you know, send off whatever. I need to get going as well, like combat wise. Okay, so I'm going to entrain the 33rd Landwehr Brigade at 1506. They're in Konigsberg. They're at 2-1, I do believe. Hold on, I'm going to check. The 33rd. Yep, everybody's full strength here. They just all got recombined. So that's a 2-4. And they're going to move to 2007 and become BG-17 with 2 strength points. So they're going to go from here, entrain. And this is the wonderful thing about German rail. So they only have 4 movement points. So that's 1 movement point to entrain, 1 movement point to rail up to, and it's 1/10 for 1 movement point. So that's 1, 2, 3. Ooh, I got to be careful though with the double tracks. So I'm going to have to go around, like, you know, when I did this one, maybe this guy should have went this way, because you'll see why. Just to be careful, because I can't go through enemy zones of control while I'm doing rail. I can go to here. Okay. So, anyways, so that's 1 to entrain, 1, 2, 3, 4. That's 2 movement points, 3, 4. Not bad, huh? Jeepers, they're amazing. And then I'm going to entrain the 21st Landwehr Brigade at 1506, doing more or less the same thing, except these guys are going to go up to here and then go to there. And they're going to be, so that's the 21st, and they're going to be BG-15. Okay, so that's 4 points. I have to take off this sucker. I'm just going to do it now, just in case. I don't want to start forgetting things, and then I think I'm not going to maybe do it for every single one, but like every step, but some would help, that's for sure. All right, then I'm going to entrain the 3rd Landwehr Brigade that's sitting in there. I'm going to entrain the 22nd Landwehr Brigade at 1506 in Konigsberg. They're going to rail the 1707 here. And that, yet again, because of the 4 movement points, it restricts me from getting there normally. So that if I did it normally, it would be 1-2 points to get across the river. Because remember, I wouldn't be entrained. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 because of the enemy zone of control. I can't do that. Because Landwehr Brigade only has 2 strength points. But, I mean, yeah, sorry, 4 movement points. So it can go, yet again, entrain for 1 movement, 1 movement point, rail for 2 movement points in total, stops here, gets off, which doesn't cost anything, 3-4. Crazy, though. And it will join the 35th, so I've got to add 2 points to that guy. Yeah, it's just remarkable. Absolutely remarkable. Otherwise, forget it. I mean, it'll take 2 turns to do it. Yeah, I love it. So this is exactly what I should have had, 5 points, because that's going to be my 36th Reserve Infantry Division. That's going to be stripped down to 1 point, and 2 of the brigades, how am I going to do, you'll see, I think it's, or maybe I'm doing it, 1 brigade and 2 regiments, and then leaving another regiment, or the Jaeger, I think it's the Jaeger Battalion, that's staying behind, actually, if I remember correctly, but we'll find out in a minute. Okay, so that guy's done. Oh, shoot. So I did that. 5, 7. Everybody's happy, I think. Yes. Now I'm going to move the 35th Infantry Division out of BG-12. These guys, they're going to hop on over. Like I said, I need to start getting these guys on over. Crossing the Prego River to join BG-4 at 1805. So now you go back to a 2. All right. And you go back up. You're going up to a 10. Makes sense, because you had 5 there, and I'm putting 5 across, so you got to trust yourself, Chris, if that's you want to play with these little Alberto markers and go away from the real counters and so on and so forth. Well, you got to pay the piper, man. Now, I'm going to move the 70th Landwehr, the Lotzen Landwehr, and the Königsberg Ersatz Brigades out of BG4. And there are a total of 5 points because the 70th Landwehr and the Lotzen Landwehr, I do believe, are 2 points. Excuse me. Anyways, so 5 points are going over to there. All right. Shuffle, shuffle, shuffle. And you go to 9. Yeah, that wooded bit there just sucks. I swear to God, man. Obviously, he knows. I'm not, like, come on, man. I'm not in that delusional. Or maybe I am and I just don't know it. Obviously, Dave Schroeder doesn't know I was going to pop a trench there. But there was at one point I was looking at him like, that little fuck. Oh, sorry. Those woods were purposely put there just in case you popped. I'm like, holy F, dude, chill. All right, so we're going to go to the next one. We're now going to move the 38th Infantry Division out of BG6, 1804, to join the 22nd and the 3rd Infantry Divisions at 1803. And they were 4 points. So now we get back to 5. Oops. Be careful. I wasn't looking. I was looking at other stuff. Excuse me. All right. And you go up to 14. I'm just trying, like you can see, I've got... Okay, this guy can kind of wait, I guess. I don't know if you can see that, but it's got 6 more turns until they become a trench. These guys, 4, 4, 4... and 6 way the heck over there. Oh, shoot, I gotta remember that too. I really will hope they keep these core HQs. Well, I'm sure they won't. But my God, that's 3 core HQs and an army HQ all jammed in together. I remembered that way back when. And in my rules now, if you nail a core HQ, that's 4 demoralization points. That's 4, 8, 12. And I think that's what? 12 points for an army HQ. That's 24. That's significant. And we just took a pounding back somewhere over there. Oh, here. Or about, well, anyway, something bad's going to happen. We know that. Okay. So I've got a 14. Where are you? There you go. There's not too much left to do. Now I'm just going to do this crazy divisional breakdown, I think. Hold on. Yeah, yep. The 9th Army HQ uses divisional breakdown on the 36th Reserve Infantry Division at 1506 in Königsberg into the Reserve Jaeger Battalion with 1 strength point in Königsberg. So I'm going to bring that down to 1 because the other guys are going to go in a minute. You'll see why. And I think after this I'm going to go and grab the cubes and see who goes. That'll be kind of neat. I hope. I will be. Anyways, I'm like, so it's certainly going to cause, like, you know, if the Russians go first, they get to react to everything. If they lose the initiative, oof. On a side note, I probably am going to start playing or put the Masuria game by Decision Games ahead on the queue. Because I want to revisit the rules, especially with the Core H. The core HQ, there's a lot of interesting things going on there, so I want to revisit that. Also, I really am looking, I know it's going to be a while, but, and I hope anybody watching this remembers to do it, and I'm going to certainly post it when I see it, when Meandering Mike does a playthrough of the Spence and Gable game. I've already got mine set up upstairs, because math and games gave me kind of the kick in the pants. I wanted to do it for age anyways. I think I mentioned that in a previous post. But the way they deal with Russian cavalry in that rule system is, to me, just brilliant. It's for two reasons. One, it works. And secondly, they explain it in the, with historicity or whatever the heck you want to call it. Like, they're like, this is what happened. And it's like, wow. It's really well done, as far as I'm concerned. Okay, so the 69th Reserve Infantry Battalion will be... they'll get 2 strength points. And also the 70th Reserve Infantry Battalion with 2 strength points. And they're both going to be entrained. And they're going to join BG-12 at 1806. Because that's all I can do. I can't get them here. I want to get them to the front as where I can. So that's an extra 4 points. I don't kind of really want them there. But like I said, at least it's better than nothing. So there we go. They're going to turn into a 6. Yeah, I've got some kind of ideas about 80%, I think, in my head of how to... play with this system, Der Weltkrieg, for my own thing, but I need to explore, like I said, some other rule systems for a bit and kind of go, okay, beg, steal, and borrow again. But, and, you know, not dissing this again is, like I've said time and time again, it's not that. I need to do things for myself and what works, and I want to play this huge, you know, war narrative and so on and so forth. Well, I got to do what I can for myself to get it to work efficiently. Yeah, that's really about it. But Der Weltkrieg, for flipping sure, is always going to be the framework. And look at this map. Stunningly designed. Just amazing. And to have the entire, you know, to be able to do the whole war at this level of detail is just... just a remark. Anyways, yep, I love it. Okay, so I think that's it. I think I've done everything right. I've got a division sitting here that's got 4 available strength points to be brought up. I've got 5 replacement units sitting there. That division hasn't moved. The headquarters hasn't moved. The replacement units haven't moved. So on this final bit, which you won't see, it doesn't matter. I'm just going to take 4 of those points and take that 36th Reserve Infantry Divit, or the remnants of it, which is the Jaeger Battalion. I'm going to have to call it something else. So look in my Deadpool or whatever you want. And that's going to get stacked up to a 5. And away we go. And it's going to get broken down again as soon as I can get some replacement unit. I'm sorry, but that's the way it goes. And yet again, I don't want to get into it. Yeah, I don't want to start bashing or whatever. It's not like I'm a, you know... I think I'm also getting into a realm, to be honest with you, where I'm slightly, more than slightly uncomfortable, because my experience level with wargaming and history and, well, war in, you know, in general is limited. And so it's like, ooh, you're getting into a realm where you don't really know what you're talking about, kind of thing. And yeah, I feel weird about it, to be honest with you. It feels very strange. But I'm going, doing what I can do. Okay, so here we go. I'm going to, let's go and find out who the hell gets to go. And this is a biggie. Should I put it near Mount Doom? Yeah, let's do it. Let's do it. So who gets to go for 01 November? Because there won't be any more combats. I think I've done every thing. If I find anything weird, I will do it. Okay, let's go. Now, hold on here. Okay. And... alright, I'll bring the dice tower down. The Nanguea dice tower. Right near Mr. Stavka. Who did I say it was? Nikolai... Yaniskevich, I do believe. Yeah, I gotta roll it on the left-hand side. It would still freak me out doing it on that, but I just need to see, because you're way over. Here, I'll bring it in more. Not too much, or how's that? And what I'll do is I'll bring. How's that? Let's see. Okay, so this is it, guys. What are we gonna see? 1 to 3, the Russians get it. 4 to 6, Central Powers. How's that? Yeah, let's do that. Or should I? No, I'm being ridiculous. Okay, so, or should I do something like odd and even? That'd be interesting. No, I don't think I've ever done that before. Okay, so who's odd and who's even? I would say that the Russians are odd because they're just one force, correct? And the even force would be the Central Powers because they have two of them. So if it's a 1, 3, or a 5, then it's going to be the Russians, and a 2, 4, or 6, it's the Central Powers. How's that? I like that one. Okay. Where are you? I don't like looking. You guys know I haven't even looked down yet. Oh, it's a cock. I'm sorry. I don't do cock dice, man. No way in hell. No way in hell. No, that's BS. Where are you? I feel you. Now, don't cock. Now, here I go. I'm going to look down. So it's a 3. So that means the Russians go first. Holy shoot. Well, I'm glad I removed these things. I wasn't going to, and I was like, well, you need to do that, Chris, because if the Russians go first, you can't have these giant whatevers. I'm not saying I'm deflated, but I don't know what the hell I was expecting. I'll bring it back a bit, but... And then I'll have to start doing... God, I wasn't even thinking Russian. I've been just so focused on... Well, maybe this is a good thing. Hold on. Oh, there we go. Jeez. Holy moly. All right. So the Russians get to go 01 November. They're going to get... I haven't even looked at their reinforcements or supply points. Obviously, they get to react to what in the world's been going on. I'm excited because I want to see what the heck Nikolai Protopopov is going to do with all this. Way over here, what the world's, they finally got their supply with Anatoly Rosenshield and an SC-1 over here. They got the fresh reinforcements from Grodno over to here, and they did some massive damage against the Germans. They can see the Germans starting to reinforce along here. We got way down this horrible, as Andrew Mike got me to come up with the idea of calling it Brusilov's blunder after he said the Russians did a major boo-boo over there. Yeah, like I said, I don't know what's going on. I'm good. I'm happy, man. Yeah, actually, I'm in a lot better shape than I was when I started the video. What the hell happened? All right, so, maybe I just needed to do this and get some good juice going for trying to think about other stuff to do. Wicked.